supposed to be a brother.
What's his name?
Abu Taymiyyah.
Where's he from?
I think London, England.
UK.
Too.
Oh, okay. UK.
He studied in Yemen also.
Yemen, yes.
Me and him had some of the same shit.
I see one of his posts that he said that a lot of people make that mistake and what they would do. You face after the face. Right? You do your arm. You're supposed to come from the fingertips to the wrist, I mean to the elbow.
And see, what he's saying is correct. The arm, the first washing of the wudu, when you first wash your hands, that's not really part of the wudu yet.
Oh, okay.
That's something that's recommended. So the Prophet used to first begin washing his right and his left. But that's not the wudu yet. Mm-hmm. That's why when you wash your hands again, you can't just start from here. Because that first washing is something like a preliminary. You do it for the muqaddamat, like in the beginning, in the introduction. But it's not the wudu. So that's why when you get to the hands again, you just can't say, I already washed this part, so now I just start from here. You can't do that. So now you're washing your hands. Allah says that you wash to your elbows. So you wash your whole hand, although you just did it, you wash your whole hand again, all the way up into your elbow. So if you start and just do this, that's incorrect. Your wudu is null and void. And if you start from your wrist to your elbow, your wudu is null and void. You have to include your whole palm and all the way up to the elbow.
Okay, being that he said that, this is what I do. Mm-hmm. When I'm washing the arm, I take the palm of water, and then I drop it down my arm, mm-hmm. and then wash it. Then I come back up like this and go between my fingers again.
I mean, that's fine. You want to use your hand to make sure you get the area.
And make sure I get my whole entire hand
the
again.
The point of Ikhwan, you have to get your whole hand.
Again.
The whole right. Every body part you wash. You have to get the whole thing except your head.
Except the head.
Your head you also have to get, but there are certain hadith that if you're wearing a scarf, not every scholar agrees, but there's some narrative hadith Hudayfa that's in the Sunan that he said, I saw the Messenger of Allah wipe over the front part of his scarf and his forehead. Mm-hmm. So many scholars, they say if you have your scarf wrapped up, that it's a Sunnah that you wipe over it. You wipe the front and you get some of your forehead. At any rate, so the head is an exception according to those who follow the hadith. Every other part, you have to get the whole body part. The second exception is your feet. When you first make your first wudu and you wash your whole foot or your whole feet with no socks, no khuf, no shoes, you wash your whole feet. After your wudu is over, if you put your socks on while you're in wudu and then you break your wudu after that, it's from the sunnah that you don't take your socks or your khufs off. But when you make your wudu, now you just wipe over your socks or khufs.
Exactly.
So your feet would be a second exception. Here you wipe over, like Ali said, the top part of your khuf or your socks.
Right. And also, I believe, correct me if I'm wrong, please, also the lihya, if it's full and big, it doesn't have to be completely drenched, soaking.
It has to be drenched, but you just have to make sure your hands, to make the tadliq, that your fingers go through your beard. You have to get your whole beard. No. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قال الإمام شيخ الإسلام محمد بن عبد الوهاب التميمي رحمه الله تعالى في كتابه ثلاثة الأصول أو ثلاثة الأصول أو أصول الثلاثة So شيخ الإسلام محمد بن عبد الوهاب continues in his أصول الثلاثة or in his ثلاثة الأصول You can say it both ways قال دليل طيب قال دليل الرجاء He says, as for the proofs of hope, that you hope with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال قوله تعالى is the statement of Allah ta'ala. فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُو لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا سُورَةُ الْكَهْفِ As Allah Ta'ala, He says in Surah Al-Kahf, And whomsoever hopes with the meeting with his Lord, then let him perform actions of righteousness. Actions of righteousness. وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّ أَحَدًا And do not allow him, or he should not, set up rivals or partners with his Lord in the worship of his Lord with anyone. Surah Al-Kahf. قال الإمام عبد العزيز بن باس في الشرح. So the Imam Ibn Abbas Man min ulama'ihi, ya Abdullah. Who's from his teachers? Who's from his students?
Al-Uthaymeen.
Ahsan. Wal-Fawzan, كذلك. قال الإمام ابن عباس وهكذا الرجاء عبادة لله. He says, and similarly, hope is from the worship of Allah. Allahu Akbar. Hoping with Allah is from worship. فَيَرَجُ اللَّهَ وَيُحْسِنُ بِهِ الظَّنِ. So the person hopes with Allah, and he always has a good thought about Allah. وَهَذَا مُهِمْ يَا إِخْوَانِ. And that's important. لَا يَجُوزُ لِلْعَبْدِ الْمُسْلِمِ أَنْ يَظُنُّ بِاللَّهِ تَعَالَى ظَنَّ السُّوءِ. هذا حرام. It's not allowed for a Muslim servant of Allah, or a servant of Allah rather, to have bad thoughts about his Lord. To have bad thoughts about his Lord. وَكَذَلِكَ إِذَا الْعَبْدُ يُوقَعُ فِي الْفِتَنَةِ أَوْ فِي الْإِمْتِحَانَاتِ لَا يَزَالُ ظَنُّهُ ظَنَّ حَسَنًا بِاللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. Even if the person is getting tested and tried, they have no food, no drink, no job, no husband, no wife, whatever the case is, being oppressed in the masjid, outside the masjid, أي فتنة ما, any test or trial, لَا يَزَالُ ظَنُّهُ حَسَنًا بِاللَّهِ. He still is supposed to have good thoughts about his Lord. رُبَّمَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى أَوْقَعَهُ فِي هَذِي الْفِتْنَةِ لِيَرَفَعَهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. Perhaps Allah from his wisdom decides to test and try this individual in order to raise him in degrees in this life and in the hereafter. In order to raise the individual. رُبَّمَا أَخْطَأَ الْمُسْلِمْ أَذْنَبَ الْمُسْلِمْ وبعد ذلك يكون من أحسن الناس عبادة لله تعالى. Perhaps a person commits a sin, he makes an error, and then he repents to Allah. And now, after that sin, he's from the most righteous of the people. وربما العبد أطاع الله تعالى وبعد ذلك يعود إلى النار. يعود إلى النار. And the opposite can take place too. A person can commit an act of obedience to Allah, but now he thinks himself to be arrogant, like many of us, boastful. أَنَا فَعَلْتُ هَذَا. I did that. أَنَا فَعَلْتُ ذَلِكَ. I'm the one who did that. أَنْتُمْ تَفْعَلُونَ هَذَا مِنْ أَجْلِ أَنَا. You guys are doing that because of me. فَيَتَكَبَّرْ وَيَتَكَبَّرْ يَتَكَبَّرْ. So now he becomes arrogant, boastful, prideful. يَسِيرُ إِلَى النَّارِ. And because of his arrogance, his pride, he goes to the hellfire. مِثْلُ الشَّيْطَانِ. Like a shaitan. وَقَعَ فِي التَّكَبُّرِ. A shaitan, from his first errors, was that he was arrogant. ظَنَّ أَنَّهُ خَيْرًا مِنْ آدَمٍ. He thought he was better than Adam. فَلَعَبْدُ لَيْسَ عَلَيْهِ أَنْ يَظُنُّ أَنَّ نَفْسَهُ خَيْرًا مِنْ شَخْصٍ آخَرٍ. لا. So it's not upon the servant to ever think that he's better than someone. وَلَوْ يَكُونُ خَيْرٌ مِنْهُ. Even if he is better than such and such. كَيْفَهُ يَعْلَمْ. How does he know? مَنْ يَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ خَيْرٌ مِنْ شَخْصٍ آخَرٍ. How can someone know who he's better than? فَالْحَاكِمْ هُوَ اللَّهُ. For indeed the true judge is not us. The judge is our Lord. رُبَّمَا عِلْمُكَ أَعْلَى مِنْ عِلْمِهِ وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ مِنْكَ. رُبَّمَا. Perhaps you have more knowledge than him. She has more knowledge than her. But the one that has the less knowledge in the sight of Allah is better. رُبَّمَا تَظُنُّ أَنَّكَ خَيْرٌ مِنْ وَلَكِنْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ هُوَ خَيْرٌ مِنْ. Perhaps you think that you're better than such and such. That's why it's so dangerous to think you're better than anyone. لا. You think you're better than such and such, but in the sight of Allah, he's way better than you. Way better. فَاللَّهُ تَعَالَى هُوَ الْحَكِيمُ. Allah is the one that's the all-wise. And Allah Ta'ala, He is the judge. فَأَمَّا نَحْنُ يَجُوزُ لَنَا أَن نَحْكُمَ بَيْنَ النَّاسِ وَنَحْكُمَ بِنِسْبَةِ إِلَى هَذَا الْفِعْلِ وَهَذَا الْقَوْلِ وَلَكِنَ الْحَاكِمُ هُوَ اللَّهِ. الْحَاكِمُ هُوَ اللَّهِ. Although, yes, it is allowed to be a judge. It is allowed. Two brothers are arguing, and you judge between their matter. That's allowed. A husband and a wife, you give them some consultation. You judge in whatever they present to you. You judge a statement. That statement is haram. You judge an action. This action is an action of kufr. But the true judge, the off judge, the everlasting judge is Allah. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال الإمام ابن باس كما قال الله تعالى. Sheikh ibn Abbas continues. He says, just as Allah Ta'ala says, فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ. So whoever hopes, Allahu Akbar, in the meeting with his Lord, فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا. Then let this person do actions of righteousness. وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا. And he should not ascribe partners with his Lord and the worship of his Lord in anything. Surah 2 Al-Kahf. قال الشيخ ابن عباس فالرغبة إليه ورجاء ما عنده. But rather the person, he desires what was his, what was that which is with his Lord, and he hopes to receive and to obtain what is with his Lord from goodness. عبادة له, out of worship to him. Allahu Akbar. وقال الله تعالى, and Allah also says, إنهم كانوا يسارعون في الخيرات ويدعوننا رغبا ورهبا وكانوا لنا خاشعين. سورة الأنبياء. Allah Ta'ala says in Surah Al-Anbiya, and they used to hasten and rush to perform actions of goodness. Look at how the Imams of the past and the Salaf were. كانوا يسارعون في الخيرات. They weren't like many of us. نتأخر ونتأخر دائما. We're always late when it comes time to do goodness. The Imams of the past, the Salaf, they used to sari'oon fil khayrat. They will rush and compete with one another upon fulfilling those actions of goodness. وَيَدْعُونَنَا رَغَبًا وَرَهَبًا. And they used to invoke us, meaning Allah, make dua to us, meaning Allah, out of love and desire and out of awe and fear. وَكَانُوا لَنَا خَاشِعِينَ. And they were humble, and they had their humility towards us, meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال الإمام ابن باز, Sheikh ibn Baz continues, قال فالرغبة الرجاء والرهب الخوف. Allahu Akbar. Sheikh ibn Baz says here in the ayah that they used to supplicate to us out of desire and love. He says this rugba, this is the hope. And when Allah Ta'ala says, and they used to make dua to us out of fear and awe, he says, this is al-khawf, this is the fear. وَكِلَاهُمَا عِبَادَةً. And both of them are worship. الرَّجَاء عِبَادَةً. Having hope for Allah. Hoping with Allah. I hope Allah allows us to such and such. I hope Allah allows the believers to come back to the jama'ah, the prayer and congregation. We hope Allah Ta'ala allows us to have lessons daily, after every salah. مَا يَمْنَعُنَا. What's stopping us? إِلَّا أَنفُسُنَا. Except ourselves. Except ourselves. We hope that Allah Ta'ala bestows upon all of us blessed and noble occupations, righteous spouses and husbands, obedient, dutiful children, guides our parents to al-Islam. نَرَجُ مِنَ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى ذَلِكَ. We hope with Allah this. وَنَخَافُ مِنَ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى الْوُقُوعِ فِي الْفِتْنَةِ. And we fear for Allah. We are fearful from Allah that He tests and tries us. وَنَخَافْ مِنَ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى أَنْ لَا نَهْدِيَنَا أَوْ لَا يَهْدِيَنَا. And we are fearful for Allah that He will not guide us. أَوْ أَنْ نَقَعْ فِي الْبِدْعَ. Or that Allah tests us by allowing us to fall into innovation. وَنَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ. فَدَائِمًا وَأَبَدًا الْمُسْلِمُ يَسْأَلُ رَبَّ الْعَافِيَةَ وَالثَّبَاتِ. All the time, ya ikhwan, the Muslim constantly ask his Lord to give him al-afiyah, a good in, good well-being, and al-thabat. And he makes his feet firm upon the book of Allah and the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah, alayhi salatu wasalam. Qala al-imam ibn Abbas, wa 'ala al-'abdi an yuhsina dhannahu bi rabbih. He says, and it's obligatory upon the servant that he has a good thought about his Lord. Wa ya'malu bil-asbab al-shar'iyyah. And he works by the legislative reasons. وَإِنَّ الظَّنَّ الْحَسَنَ مَعَ الْأَخْذِ بِالْأَسْبَابِ. And having a good thought is working by those al-asbab. فَمَثَلًا الْعَبْدُ لَهُ صُدَاعٌ. The servant has a headache. يَجُوزُ لَهُ أَنْ لَا يَمْشِيَ إِلَى الْمُسْتَشْفَى إِلَى الطَّبِيبِ. It's allowed for him to say, I'm going to be patient. I'm not going to a doctor. I'm not going to the hospital. It's allowed. But him going to the hospital and taking the medication that they give him, As long as he understands that the cure is not in this Tylenol. The cure is not in this medication. The cure is with Allah. But the Tylenol is the asbab, is the means that which Allah Ta'ala is bringing you the cure. But the cure is with Allah. Two different things. Both of them are allowed. You can say, no, I'm going to be patient, alhamdulillah. My knee is bothering me. I'm not going to go to the doctor. I tawakkal ala Allah. I'm going to put my trust upon Allah. Hada ja'iz. That's allowed. Wa idha aqul mathalan, ana sa'amshi ila al-mustashfa. But if I say, I'm going to get my leg checked out. That's also allowed. That's also allowed. فَهَذَا الْأَخْذُ بِالْأَسْبَابِ. This is taken from the means. The asbab. The legislative means. That's allowed, ya ikhwan. Many Muslims think, oh, no, no, no. You can't go to the doctors. It's not correct. You can go to the doctor. But you have to have the Islamic belief when you go to the doctor. He gives you the medication, and then your headache, Allahu Akbar, disappears. Goes away. You say, oh, the Tylenol cured me. La. That's a mistake. Allah Ta'ala, huwa shafi. Allah Ta'ala is the one that cured you by way of this medication. Two different things. قال الإمام ابن باز ويعمل بالأسباب الشرعية and he works by the legislative means وإن الظن الحسن مع الأخذ بالأسباب يعود على العبد بالخير. He says, and having the good thoughts and taking the legislative means will return the servant to the goodness وبالرحمة and with mercy وبدخول الجنة and by way of it he will enter to the Jannah وبمغفرة الذنوب and he will have his sins forgiven. فنتوقفون إن شاء الله تعالى يا إخوان. So we'll stop there إن شاء الله. عند دليل التوكل. And the next point is the proofs of placing your trust upon Allah. فكون متكلمين عن هذا. We just mentioned that. طيب. So we'll stop there يا إخوان. For our brothers and sisters online, نتوقف هنا. We'll stop there إن شاء الله. If no one has anything to put forth, any corrections or the likes, فسبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك فنسبت فمن الله وإن أخطأت فمن نفسي. Anything that we said that's correct is from Allah. Anything we said is incorrect is from ourselves. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.